عن ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما. الحديث سنده حسن، حسنه الشيخ ناصر رحمه الله. بيروف الحديث في صحيح ابن حبان ومعجم الطبراني and also I believe in مسند الإمام البزار. عبد الله بن عمر says كنت أو كنا جلوسا مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في مسجد بمنى. We were sitting with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in a masjid in Mina during Hajj, during the days of Hajj. فجاءه رجلان, two individuals, two of the companions who are performing Hajj came to him. فسلم عليه. They said السلام عليك يا رسول الله. فرد عليهم السلام, قال السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. فone of them spoke and he said جئنا نسألك. We came to ask you. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم right away he interrupted the questioner and he said إن شئت أخبرتك بما جئت لتسأل عنه وإن شئت فسل. If you want I can tell you what you're coming to ask about, and if you want I will hold back and you go ahead and ask your question. فقال الرجل الصحابي هذا أخبرنا يا رسول الله. Tell us, O Messenger of Allah, what we came to ask about. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, جئت لتسأل عن خروجك من بيتك تأم بيت الله الحرام وما لك فيه. You came to ask about you leaving your home and going to the house of Allah and what reward you have in there. وجئت لتسأل, and you came to ask عن ركعتيك بعد الطواف خلف المقام وما لك فيهما. And you came to ask about the reward of the two rak'ahs that you pray behind the station of Ibrahim after you complete your tawaf and your reward. وجئت لتسأل عن طوافك بين الصفا والمروة وما لك فيه. And you came to ask about you walking between the two mountains, the Safa wal Marwa, and your reward, what you get. وجئت لتسأل عن وقوفك عشية عرفة وما لك فيه. You came to ask about you standing, your standing in the place of gathering in the day of Arafah, in the gathering of Arafah, and the reward that you have in it. وجئت لتسأل, and you came to ask about you throwing the pebbles, رمي الجمار. وجئت لتسأل عن رمي الجمار وما لك فيه. وجئت لتسأل عن حلقك لشعرك وما لك فيه. And you came to ask about you shaving your head and what you have in it. وجئت لتسأل, and you came to ask about your ذبح, that you sacrifice the nusuka which you slay in the Hajj and your tawaf. Basically, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم named the pillars and the duties of Hajj in this hadith. Here is the answer. Of course, the companion said, Wallahi ya Rasulallah, by Allah, O Messenger of Allah, عن هذه جئنا لنسأل. About this we came to ask. أما عن خروجك من بيتك تأم البيت الحرام. As for you leaving your house, aiming at the house of Allah, فلا ترفع دابتك خفا ولا تضع إلا ومحى الله عنك ذنب وكتب لك حسنة. Every step that you make to the house of Allah, accept Allah will erase a sin and write a good deed for you. And as for the two rak'ahs behind the maqam, it equals freeing a neck from the offspring of Ismail. عتق رقبة, عتق كعتق رقبة من ولد إسماعيل. As for your walking, your tawaf between الصفا والمروة, it equals freeing 70 necks from slavery. كعتق 70 رقبة, لك أجر. عتق 70 رقبة, you receive the reward of freeing 70 slaves from slavery. And as for you standing, عشية عرفة, on the day of عرفة, in the mountain of عرفة, فإن الله يدنو. Indeed, Allah سبحانه وتعالى descends. ونحن نؤمن أن الله يدنو. نثبت لله صفة الدنو وصفة التنزل. لا نعطلها ولكن لا نشبهها ولا نمثلها ولا نكيفها. We believe that Allah descends. We believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends. But how he descends? I don't know. Should I try to find out? No, you should not. Because you know what? Whatever you reach in your mind, كل ما دار ببالك فالله بخلاف ذلك. Allah is above that. اسمع هذه يا أخي. لا يعلم كيف الله إلا الله. Only Allah knows how Allah is. Once it comes to his names and attributes. So we believe that Allah will descend on the people who are standing on the mountain of Arafah. ويقول لملائكته. Then he will say to his angels, انظروا إلى عبادي. Look at my servants. أتوني شعثا غبرا. They came to me dusted, disheveled, من كل فج عميق, from every distant valley, يرجون رحمتي ويخافون عذابي. They are hoping in my mercy and they are fearful of my punishment. والله لو, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if their sins equals the number of the sand, even if their sins equal the drop of rain, the foam of the sea, I have forgiven them. And I have forgiven also those to whom they made dua for. أشهدكم يا ملائكتي أني قد غفرت لهم وغفرت لكل من شفعوا له. And as for your reward, for throwing the pebble, for each pebble that you throw, every jamrah that you throw, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala كفر عنك من الموبقات. One of the destructive sins is expiated. And as for you shaving or shortening your hair, every strand, every piece of hair that fall down, a sin is erased, a hasana is written. And as for them sacrificing, فهذا عندي, it is stored with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as for their tawaf, tawaf al-ifadha, Subhanallah, a scene out of this world. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, an angel comes and pushes the haji and tells him, think about the future now, your past is taken care of. لا ينكر هذا. Someone who deprives himself from this, there is something wrong with him, ya ikhwa. This person's agenda is not forgiveness. This person's agenda is not to break even. If you are able, I understand that Hajj is a restricted pillar in the sense of if you're able. But why in the world, if you're able, you deprive yourself from that? At least every 5 years, give it a umrah. In the wording of this hadith, ya ikhwa, من حج فلم يرفث ولم يفسق رجع من ذنوبه كيوم ولدته أمه. The wording with the Imam Muslim. من أتى هذا البيت. من أتى. Whoever comes to this house. So if you have performed your mandatory حج and you cannot afford the package of حج or your physical cannot, go for Umrah. العمرة إلى العمرة كفارة لما بينهما. Brothers and sisters in Islam, one of the most fascinating, and I close with this, things about Hajj, that you end up to be in the best place in the face of this earth at the best time. أي فضل. The best place at the best time. The best place is Mecca, باتفاق لقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. When he went out, when he was expelled, he made that statement. والحديث صحيح. والله, by Allah, إني لأعلم أنك أحب بلاد الله إلى الله يا مكة. I know that you are the most beloved spots, places in earth to Allah. ولولا أن قومك أخرجوني ما خرجت. And has it been for them expelling me, I would not have left you. So you end up in the best place at the best time of the year. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم أفضل أيام الدنيا أفضل أيام الدنيا أيام العشر من ذي الحجة. The best days out of the year are the 10 days of ذي الحجة, which is coming up in 10 days almost. ما من أيام العمل الصالح فيهن أحب إلى الله من تلك الأيام, يعني العشرة. ف don't deprive yourself, brothers and sisters in Islam. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم اكتب لنا حجا وعمرة. اللهم اكتب لنا حجا وعمرة. اللهم اكتب لنا حجا وعمرة. اللهم تقبل منا يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وعافنا واعف عنا. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. اللهم أصلح لنا ديننا الذي هو عصمة أمرنا, وأصلح لنا دنيانا التي فيها معاشنا, وأصلح لنا آخرتنا التي إليها معادنا, واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير, واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر. اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين, وأعلي بفضلك كلمتي الحق والدين. اللهم انصر عبادك المستضعفين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم, وأقم الصلاة.